Yeah. So hi everyone. This is the talk of effect on the frontend. So one of the few talks on effect on the frontend, and we will go over like why I think effect is ideal on the frontend. This bold claim comes from like more than 3 years working on production frontend code bases. Like 3 years is a long time, especially in like the effect ecosystem. And the whole purpose of this talk is going around like when, how, and why. Specifically, we're going like starting from when. So there are some cases on the front end where you definitely don't want to use effect, or you don't care about using effect, and we will see that. We will go into how, and these are like quick step by step on how I create a project on the front end and use effect on it. And then we will go into why, also like why there are a lot of things to say. We will go into like some really concrete example that will show you on the benefit of effect on the front end. So starting from when to use effect on the front end, the answer is simple. It's like everything that has business logic on it. So in this era of like front end work, this is like everything around React Server components, worker loaders, and also state management. And instead of like showing you some like code samples here, I will show you some real examples from real code bases. These are like production code bases that I have, some private, some not, all using effect on the front end. So you can see here an example. So this is a React Server component. I usually get like a main function on the top. This is using all effect services. And then you like just run promise and get the results here. And this is like React Server components. So this is technically server, but it's still on the front end. And another example here I have for workers. So everything is front end. Think of it like everything on the front end side. So it is like Nest.js, VTAP, your standard VTAP. Here like browser, so effect platform here, all the effect modules, and you just get four lines with services. Everything is testable, everything is it's here. So two examples, React Server components and workers here. When he said you don't want to use effect on the front end, and the answer is like, when you have anything to do like styling, layout, animations, this is a huge chunk on the front end. So if you ever work on the front end side, you have to deal with like, you have a design and you have to create it on the front end. And this is like where effect, it's not at all present. So if you are just like building like components, styling, don't use effect. And I will show you here. So I have a components folder, and here the components are like your standard front-end components, and here there is no trace of effect. So you won't find anything. These are like all styling, whatever styling library are you using, all like components and stuff, and there is no trace of effect, unless you're they're taking like state management, but this is like another topic. So this is the answer for when, and then we are going to like how, and this is like really going to tactical details of specifically how we create a project, and now I'm using it on the front-end for effect. So first thing first, you just PMPM add effect. And this is not obvious, but that's really all the thing you need. So all your TypeScript configuration, all your config, linting, it's everything there. And it's not obvious, especially for some of these libraries at this scale. Second, services. So I usually create like straight away, this is like Nest.js project, a lib folder inside and services inside it. And I can show you here. So you have like lib and services. And these are all the services that you will create on the front end. You will always find in all my open source project, this services folder here. You can find it as well on this other project here, lib and services. And you will basically store all the services here, implement them. It's easy to like to track and to implement as well. First step, it's effect.service. A lot of people talking about effect.service, not enough examples here, because I think it's like the core API that we definitely use a lot, especially on the front end. So inside the lib, we see like all these services here. And a service is basically all these services are using this effect.service API. For example, here for MDX, we want to convert some like string to some representation for the frontend. So you install whatever package it as outside, in this case, MDX.js. And then you usually create this like class with effector service. You have some dependencies inside it. These dependencies are internal to the project. So you can see here, these are other services inside the services folder. So these are like all the composition abilities for effect. You can use dependencies here. Probably the first time that you in this conference that we've seen this, but you can just provide dependencies and layers inside effector service. So it's packing everything in one API. And then you do your implementation. This is like the details of your app. It doesn't really matter right now, but you provide this like API that returns effect. You can see here, you give a string and you return whatever effect with all the arrows tracked here. And so all the other services are the same. So you will see like all of these are like effect.service, all of here, and the same for the other example that the other code base that I show you. So third step, fourth step is like a runtime. I find really great to create a runtime out of the services. So you can see here outside, inside the lib folder, out of the services folder, we have a runtime client and a runtime server. This is for Next.js specifically, where you have like both server and client. And effects allows you to like extract all the layers from effector service that we saw like in the services here. You take the service that should run on the server in this case, and you basically like, put all of them in a main layer. These layers, you can see, will contain all your services. And then you put everything in a manager runtime. We saw this also like yesterday. And you have like this runtime that is basically able to learn any kind of effect using the listed services here. And this is for the server and the same for the client. So I have another one for the client. These are like specific for the client. And then you can like just run promise on it, the five step. So you go, as you saw before, like in your whatever server component here. And you create the main at the top using some services, in this case, like the content service and the metadata here. And you can also like use whatever other package or module that effect offers you. So you see here like array and order. This is great. For example, here in a few lines of code, you can sort all the articles by the updated date. And it's all is backed by schema, so it's great as well. And you get the final main here that contains the result for your component, whatever error tracked on the type level, and also like the services that are required here. And you can just use the runtime server and call run main, run promise, and just get back the result. This would work because the runtime server here, you can see, provides like both metadata and content here, which are required by main here. And so you don't even have to think a lot about it. You just create the service, as we saw. You create the service, you put everything in a runtime, and you just run promise whatever you need. So this was all the how. And then just go into why. For the why, I will just show you like a couple of examples. We can go like a long list of why you would want to use effect on the front end. I will show you a couple of examples so we can get like pretty tactical on the example that I showed you in the code base before. First is like error handling. So as we saw here, main tracks all the errors that can happen anywhere in whatever main you created. And so in this case, you can just run promise and the rectangle component would fail. But you can also like just pipe here, write a pipe and check for whatever error using something like catch tag or catch tags. So you get all the errors here. And you can also like, decide to provide like an error message to the user on the front end. Especially this is great because oftentimes you end up with like something happen and this is not really great on the front end. So you can decide to catch whatever error all tracked on the background. And you don't even like really need to care where this error originate or why they happen, as long as you have enough information to show a message to the user. The second one, it's like you have no more issue, especially for like something like Next.js, to run server code on the client and vice versa. So as we mentioned, we create two runtimes, one for the client and one for the server. That's because all the services that are listed here will not be bundled in the client. these are like all server stuff, and that's why they are contained in this runtime server. And this means that if you try to run something using a runtime client on the server, you will get a compile time error. This is like an error that you can like spot right away, because it says that the content and the metadata, which are required by main, as we saw here, these two services are required to run the system, are not assignable to RPC client. And that's because the runtime client doesn't have these services inside it. So there is like no issue at all to running something that should be on the server. So it should run like something like Node or whatever on the client and vice versa. Like for example, there are some cases with state management where you want to like use some browser API and you pack a service inside runtime client. And there is no chance to have any kind of runtime error in this case, because everything is on the runtime of the client and not the server. So you won't mix and match them, because you get compile time error for everything. And then there are like a lot of like other things that I can talk about. There is no time here, but immutable data structure, which are great for something like React immutable updates. So use state, use HashMap, HashSet from Effect. As we other talked about, like Gradle adoption, just TypeScript, and things like Effected Platform and Platform Browser are great for HTTP call. Web workers, as we saw here, come from Platform. You can just work and run, and you don't need to care like how it works, shutdown, interruption, and everything. So these are all the benefits. I talk about this and a lot more, like local first payments, and with all example, all open source, all free, on TypeScript.dev. Specifically, I have like a course for beginners. It's like made completely for beginners. It's like the kind of resource that I wanted for me as I was getting started with Effect. I wrote all down here. You can check it out in the link. And another more specific for Effect with React 19. This is like setting up a project with Effect on the front end using all the new patterns with React 19. Also here, you can check it out. This was me. I'm Sandro, and you can check me out at TypeScript.dev. All the links are there, DMs, whatever, and that was it. Thank you.